Dave Calabro has the night off. Dick Rea is in the 13 Sports Jam studio. Let's see what's happening there, Dick.
Well, Rory, lots of action on the racetracks. That's what holiday weekends are all about. The Indy Racing League playing host to another packed house in Kansas City. The hot driver in today's 200-mile race didn't quite make it to the finish line. That set the stage for more controversy. We'll have some reaction. Why is Tamika Catchings of the Fever all smiles tonight? We'll tell you about an important date coming up in her immediate future. And some remembrances of baseball great Ted Williams from those who encountered the splendid splinter.
Hi, everybody. Tree Boy here with an update on the Estridge Channel 13 Showcase Home. As you can see, the house is really starting to take shape. I'll be telling you about some exciting upgrades on Eyewitness News through June. So keep watching Channel 13. In the coming weeks, I'll also tell you how you can bid on this fabulous house. Remember, proceeds from the sale will benefit Riley Hospital for Children.
The Showcase Home is brought to you in part by Fifth Third Bank and Godby Home Furnishings. Proceeds benefit Riley Hospital for Children. It's the forecast Central Indiana is talking about.
The SkyTrack personal forecast is terrific. Thank you, WTHR, once again for providing the best.
It's a wonderful way to find out what the day may bring during the school year and in the summer.
Thanks, WTHR, for giving us even better tools to keep us safe.
If you haven't signed up for the SkyTrack personal forecast, here's how to do it. Go to WTHR.com, click on the icon, and follow the instructions. The SkyTrack personal forecast, only on WTHR.com. Channel 13 Eyewitness News has opened a new weather window, and it's just a few clicks away. Log on to WTHR.com for the latest forecast from the SkyTrack weather team. You'll also see live Doppler 9000 radar and traffic eye cameras to steer you through the drive ahead. It's SkyTrack weather on the web with news updates from MSNBC on WTHR.com.
Are you having a rough summer?
It's the dog days of summer sale.
Big 24-foot pool packages, only $12.99.
Spas, $16.99.
Patio furniture.
That's Watson's.
People aren't just stopping at BP Connect for what's outside, but also for what's inside. The Wild Bean Cafe, with hot and hearty, hunger-taming sandwiches, crisp, cold salads, fresh-from-the-oven cookies, sparkling cold beverages, and delicious Wild Bean coffee. Now, feeding your appetite is as easy as filling your tank. BP Connect.
Now get two delicious, fresh-baked cookies free when you purchase any sandwich or salad at BP Connect.
No roaming. Nationwide. Did I mention furry? Of course you have to be on our network, not their network, or network or something.
Don't get trapped. Get Singular Nation. Never pay long distance, never pay roaming. It's that simple.
By free, we don't mean without charges. There will be charges, of course, what I'm trying to say.
Self-expression is simple with Singular Nation.
This is your appetite talking. How about something tasty?
Introducing Arby's Market Fresh Ultimate BLT.
Ooh, the bread is so soft. All that bacon, so peppery. And those toppings, so fresh.
Arby's new Market Fresh Ultimate BLT.
BLTs me.
Made fresh to order. It'll change the way you think about fast food.
Give in to your grown-up tastes.
Sports Jam.
Tonight on the Jam, another controversial finish for the Indy Racing League. A second chance restart leaves Sam Hornish seething. And the Pacers.
He feels happy about himself. Let him. I mean, then he tries to run me down off the track into turn three. And that's, you know, you try to play by the rules, and I want to do everything by the rules, and I don't want to say anything bad about anybody. So.
And the Pacers reload for another season. We'll check out the hopefuls at this weekend's free agent rookie camp. You don't want to miss this week's Whole Ball of Wax. It's a week's worth of rumbling, stumbling moments from the sports world. Good evening. Welcome to the 13th Sports Jam. Dave Calabro has the night off. Hope you had a fantastic holiday weekend. I'm Dick Rea. It certainly was a great weekend for A.J. Foyt. After waiting over 3 years to get back to the winner's circle, A.J., made two different trips today in Kansas City, but his latest win on the Indy Racing League circuit didn't come without a little controversy. The man in charge for most of the race today was Thomas Schechter, making the pass on Ayrton Daré, the pole sitter leading 101 of the 200-lap event. Looked like this would be the week that Schechter would make it to the winner's circle, but after battling Sam Hornish, Schechter runs into problems again. Out in front all by himself, he crashes with 9 laps to go in the race. There was confusion on the restart. Sam Hornish got the jump on the first restart, but the yellow comes out because the back markers let Ayrton Daré go by. Then on the second restart, Hornish and his team contend they were caught off guard and out of gear, and that led to Daré being able to make his move and get around Hornish with just 3 laps to go. Ayrton Daré goes on to capture his first IRL victory for car owner A.J. Foyt. A.J. hadn't been in the winner's circle since 1999 when he was there with Kenny Breck, so it was a very emotional time for Daré and A.J. Here's a look at the top five as Sam Hornish Jr. gets a second-place finish. Elio Castroneves keeps his hold atop the point standings with a third-place finish. Felipe Giafone fourth, and Gilles Deferrin rounding out the top five.
He had a little bit of problems going through the gears. I think he missed a gear coming out of the corner, and then that happens when you get too excited on the restart.
If he feels happy about himself, then let him. I mean, then he tries to run me down off the track into turn three, and that's, you know, you try to play by the rules, and I want to do everything by the rules, and I don't want to say anything bad about anybody. So just want to thank the Pencil Panther team. They did an awesome job for me today. Race was ours.
Well, it was a history-making day for the Champ Car Series as Cristiano D'Amata joined a very exclusive club at the street course in Toronto. The honorary starter, Alex Zanardi, making his first appearance at a racetrack since last fall's horrific accident. On the start of the race, Paul Tracy jumps pole sitter Cristiano D'Amata. That brings out the yellow flag for the false start. 24 laps to go in the race. Tracy's day comes to an end when his brakes fail and he spins out. Tracy with a 16th place finish today. Onto the final lap, D'Amata leading this race wire to wire and claims his fourth straight kart win, becoming only the third driver to win 4 kart races in a row, joining Zanardi and Al Unser Jr. Top five at the Toronto Molson Indy. D'Amata coming in first, Kenny Breck in second, Christian Fittipaldi third, Shinji Nakano in fourth, and Scott Dixon driving for Chip Ganassi. At the Formula One British Grand Prix, Rubens Barrichello was supposed to start second, but he stalled on the formation lap and had to move back to the rear of the pack. Then hard rain fell on the circuit at Silverstone, England. On lap 16, pole sitter Juan Montoya slides. Michael Schumacher in the red Ferrari slips past him for the lead. Late in the race, Barrichello making the move on Montoya. They nearly touch. Barrichello moving up into second place all the way from the back. A race dominated by the Ferraris and Schumacher. For Schumacher, his 60th Grand Prix victory. His teammate coming home in second, Rubens Barrichello. Juan Pablo Montoya still looking for a win, coming in third. Jacques Villeneuve in fourth. And Olivier Panis rounding out the F1 top five. Closer to home, the Hydroplanes running for the Governor's Cup in Southern Indiana this weekend. Miss Elam Plus winning the Madison Regatta with Nate Brown at the controls. It's the third win in 4 races for Brown, who's from Preston, Washington. Brown seemed to have the speed advantage all weekend. He did get some help on the final heat. The pilot of Miss Troxilla let his foot off the throttle. Miss Budweiser came home in third. Miss Madison, by the way, failed to reach the final heat, losing in the last chance race. And for the second straight year, the Indiana Fever will be represented at the WNBA All-Star Game, but rookie sensation Tamika Catchings will be the first Fever player to start for the Eastern All-Stars, July 15th in Washington. Catchings was second in the East voting to Shamika Holdsclaw of the Mystics. Tamika Catchings leads the Fever in scoring at over 18 points a game, clearly the top rookie in the league. Last year, Rita Williams of the Fever was a reserve on the East squad.
It makes me feel really good, you know, just coming out here. Like you said, it's my rookie season. A lot of people haven't had the opportunity to see me, but from what they've seen, you know, I guess it's been pretty well. A lot of people voted for me, but it's really exciting, and I just want to thank everybody that voted for me.
Yeah, great honor for Tamika Catchings. There's a look at the other teammates on that East squad. Kari Phillips of New York, Teresa Weatherspoon, along with Don Staley out of Charlotte. On the West, Cheryl Swoops out of Houston, Tina Thompson, Lisa Leslie from the defending champion, Sue Bird out of Seattle, Sacramento also well represented in the WNBA All-Star Game. The tennis wasn't very entertaining, but if you skipped watching the men's final at Wimbledon this morning, you missed another classic moment, or maybe I should say classless is a better way to put it. For the second time in 6 years, a streaker interrupted play during the men's final. It happened during the second set between Leighton Hewitt and David Nalbandi, and it took about 2 minutes for security to get things back in order. Didn't seem to bother Hewitt as the top seed went on to post one of the most lopsided victories in recent Wimbledon history, beating Nalbandi in three sets. The day after capturing her first Wimbledon singles title, Serena Williams teamed up with her sister Venus to capture the doubles championship. The Williams sisters combined have now won three of the last women's singles titles at Wimbledon. And at the U.S. Women's Open Golf, problems for the third round leader, Annika Sorenstam, with a bogey on the 15th hole that opened the door for Julie Inkster. The American capitalizing under pressure and captures the Open in Hutchinson, Kansas, with a two-stroke victory over Sorenstam. Inkster shot a 4-under par 66 today in winning her second U.S. Open title, and again, the only American to win that event in the last 8 years. The Indianapolis Indians finished their two-game series at Toledo with a split against the Mud Hens, the Tribe winning this afternoon 5-3. They head to the All-Star break 4 games below the 500 mark. Meanwhile, the Reds trying to hang with the Cardinals, but they have problems with the Brewers today. Alex Sanchez driving in a run, but Paul Bacco is gunned down trying to sneak in at home. Todd Walker helping the Reds get the lead with a two-run shot in the second as the Reds take the lead. The Reds had bases loaded in the fifth, but Sean Casey wastes the opportunity as he flies out into left field. The Reds fall 2 games behind St. Louis, losing today to the Brewers 7-4. Up next on the 13 Sports Jam, Bob Kravitz of the Indianapolis Star is in the house, and he has some interesting observations coming off this week's ruling of the Indy 500 appeal of Team Green.
Hearing all of the evidence, was something that we felt we should give the teams an opportunity to present their case.
And we'll take you to Conseco Fieldhouse, where the Pacers are getting acquainted with their top draft pick, Fred Jones.
No, whoa, I want this transaction.
Who's Daddy talking to, Mommy?
I want to talk to somebody.
He's talking to the cash machine, dear.
At Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, there's no substitute for personal service. With over 130 offices and a 24-hour customer service center, we've made service the cornerstone of our commitment to you.
Doesn't Daddy know cash machines don't talk?
There we go.
I think he knows.
For solutions and service you can depend on.
Can I get somebody to help me?
Call Farm Bureau Insurance.
Pam Anderson bears skin and soul. Next Extra, from the body part she loves to the tattoo she hates.
There was no question she would answer.
Pammy exposed. Then a dog-eat-dog exclusive.
Let it rain!
Kato Conger and Hatch's celebrity deathmatch. And the hunky perfume model turned Extra celebrity reporter. Plus, three wild things you never knew about MTV's Johnny Knoxville. Next Extra.
Monday at 7 on Channel 13.
Are you having a rough summer?
It's the Dog Days of Summer Sale. Save 20 to 50% on all pools.
Big 24-foot pool packages, only $12.99. Guaranteed lowest prices on all pools. 6 months, same as cash.
Get the best spas at the best prices, like Cal Spas and Viking Spas, as low as $16.99.
Brand name patio furniture. 5-piece sets, only $3.99.
Toys, games, and pool supplies. Beat the heat and save money.
See you at Watson's.
Hey, Indiana, Job Connection is now the hiring network. It's still the same great interactive website, and now we've joined forces with Employment Source Magazine. Your best source for local jobs is better than ever. From accounting to sales, computers to nursing, our online job information is easy to access and easy to use. Plus, you'll find Employment Source at over 1,000 area locations. So take that first step in starting your new career. Check out Employment Source Magazine and Hiring Network today.
To just, you know, call up and say, Barry, I don't care what you have, it doesn't matter. I suppose we could have done that. I don't know, again, that he would have accepted that any better than he necessarily will accept this decision today.
Welcome back to the 13 Sports Jam. An important week for auto racing as the long-awaited ruling came down from Tony George, denying the appeal of Team Green over the controversial finish of the 500 and affirming the victory of Elio Castroneves. Bob Kravitz of the Indianapolis Star was at Wednesday's press conference, joins us here tonight. Bob, welcome.
Thanks.
I know none of us were really that surprised about the decision that Tony George made, but I think we kind of walk away from this maybe even more confused than ever.
Scratching our heads. Yeah, again, it's the rationale for the decision, not the decision itself. The rationale, which I think leaves us all sort of fuzzy-headed. If this was not appealable or protestable, they could have told us all that 5 weeks ago.
And you think of all the hours that have been spent poring over that videotape of the moment in question, the pass that was made, and all the technology that should be or is available. And what do we make out of that?
What we make of that is I don't know what we make of that. It's so amazing to me, again, with all that technology. It's one thing not to have a decision made that day, but 5 weeks after the case, you would think they'd have a coherent decision, and they didn't. And they said that after-the-fact data meant nothing.
Well, it was an interesting press conference, to say the least. So what we want to do now is let's take you back to Wednesday morning. The decision's been announced. Speedway President Tony George has read all of his notes, and now he's taking some questions from the press, and Bob Kravitz, it seems, puts him on the spot.
If the evidence had shown otherwise, that Tracy was ahead, are you suggesting that because of the way the rule is stated in the rule book, that a protest, that this sort of thing can't be challenged, that you couldn't overturn it anyway?
The evidence that was reviewed, but based on Brian's determination at the time, if he would have called the race the other way, I would have to stand by the rule as it's written, based on whatever the evidence may have been.
You're saying this is not. I'm sorry. You're saying this is not something that really can be protested. The order of the cars at the yellow cannot.
The officials call.
Right. So
for either a call for caution or a judgment call cannot be protested.
Right. So getting back to John's question, what was this all about? If it couldn't be overturned.
The protest was heard and subsequently appealed, and we followed the procedures for appeal. Hearing all of the evidence was something that we felt we should give the teams an opportunity to present their case, and I'm not sure that it would have changed the outcome at all in any event, but again, after reviewing, you know, the rules, and you know, in the interest of the parties concerned, that we just felt that it was important to continue with the appeal.
It seemed like a very awkward and some uncomfortable moments there for the Speedway president.
I don't know if that was a pregnant pause or brain freeze. I mean, does that come with subtitles? Maybe the people out there understand what he was trying to say. I to this day, I still have no clue what he was trying to impart to us there. You know, I wasn't trying to badger the witness, but again, I come back to this. Brian Barnhart signed off on an appeal and a protest. To me, that moved this issue out of the realm of the judgment call and made it something that could be adjudicated based on the hard evidence. Well, he's coming back now and saying, no matter what you showed me, it wasn't going to make any difference. Well, why couldn't you have told poor Barry Green that 5 weeks ago before he spent a couple $100,000? And I think Barry Green is asking that same question.
Well, I know it's been well documented that this supposedly is the final word on this incident, but spending some time with Barry Green and hearing from him, do you think he has any grounds to go to the next step if there is one?
Well, you know, I'm not a lawyer. I did watch L.A. Law once, so I guess that makes me someone who can make a decision here. But it seems to me that he spent a lot of money for no reason. He was told initially, you can protest this based on hard factual evidence, and now he's being told, sorry, no matter what was brought to the table, it wasn't going to matter. And yeah, I would certainly try to get some of my money back. This was basically a review of the race on Barry Green's dime. It should have been a protest. It was never that.
What do you think this says about the credibility right now? The Indy Racing League is trying to compete not only with CART, but let's face it, NASCAR is way ahead of open wheel racing right now. Does this just make things even worse for them?
Yeah, I think it certainly, it was great to have this race in the news for five additional weeks, but I think this does undercut once again the credibility of the sport. I don't know racing that well. I think we've already determined that many times over. One thing I have learned since I've been following racing is they seem to make the rules as they go along.
All right, well, we're also following basketball season. The Pacers having their rookie and free agent camp, and I know you've been spending some time down at Conseco checking out some of the new faces.
Yeah, one guy who really interests me a lot, and a guy I wrote about in tomorrow's paper, is Charlie Bell, who just, you know, 2 years ago was down at the RCA Dome winning a national title for Michigan State. Since that time, I think he's been with 6, 7, 8 different teams. He's been in the NBDL, the ABA. He's been over in Italy. This is a guy who is trying to catch on with the team, and I think he's a very good fit for the Pacers as a third guard.
How about Fred Jones, the top draft pick, a first look at him? I know he had some injury problems coming into this camp, but it looks like he's ready to go.
Pacers are very happy with him early on. He's showing what a lot of us saw out in Sacramento when Indiana was out there. The guy is a great athlete. He can create his own shot. And Isaiah Thomas said from the beginning he wanted a creator, somebody who could make something out of nothing. And this guy fits that bill.
You think the Pacers are now starting to position themselves for life after Reggie Miller?
I think a little bit. I don't know if this is necessarily the guy who's going to replace Reggie, but you know, he is a good shooter. I mean, he's a 52% shooter, and that's not bad. And he was basically the focus of their offense at Oregon. So I think, you know, I mean, he's not a stop-and-shoot kind of guy like Reggie, but I think he's a guy who could try to start to fill that void.
You mentioned Charlie Bell. Anything else we can look forward to reading about in the Star this week?
Well, look for our new look in the Star. I'm curious to see. I'm just hoping the new column picture isn't all that awful. They don't have much to work with.
Bob, we appreciate your observations, right. Okay. And we appreciate you coming in tonight. And stay with us. We have much more tonight on the Pacers and rookie free agent camp when we come back on the 13 Sports Jam. And we'll also take a look back at the great baseball career of Ted Williams and the impact he had right here in Central Indiana.
The 13 Sports Jam is brought to you in part by your Central Indiana Dodge dealer.
Bold, powerful, and a great way to get to work. Dodge. Introducing Stratus SXT. Wheels, tunes, and our 7100 powertrain pledge for around 16.7.
Self-service was introduced to make our lives easier, but too often, it can make the world feel like a cold and lonely place. At Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, providing full service is the most important thing we do.
Hi, pump number two! Not working!
You can't use pump number two, it's not working. Try pump number one.
Thanks!
For full service you can depend on, call Farm Bureau Insurance.
The 2002 World Basketball Championship is coming to Indianapolis August 29th through September 8th. And great seats are on sale now for as low as $10 a session. Lower level seats are still available on a first-come, first-served basis. And you can choose the games you want to see. Experience the electricity as the U.S. enters the deepest tournament in basketball history. The best, discovering who is better. One team to stand above all others. With the title of World Champion.
So, Jeff, Susie's told us a lot about you, but she didn't tell us what you do.
Oh, Coors Light.
Is that good money?
I made 20 bucks last week, but I made a million today.
This summer, Coors Light and Coors Original are giving away cash. Lots of cash. Thousands of winners. There's also $1 million up for grabs each day, every day. Look for the specially marked packs of Coors Light or Coors Original for your shot at the cash.
You know, if it doesn't work out with Susie, she's got a sister.
Sweet.
The
Pacers wasting little time getting things together in their house. They get Fred Jones signed on Friday, then on the job Saturday. Eric Waxler has more on the man they took as their number one pick.
For a guy who doesn't have a car in town, Fred Jones seems to be driving pretty well. The Pacers' first-round pick is off to a flying start in the team's summer camp.
I'm not under any pressure, I mean, from anybody except myself. I mean, that's the only person I got to please out here. You know, when I feel that I'm playing my best, then, you know, I'll be happy.
He's a beast. He's good. You know, he's under pressure, got a good pick. You know, real athletic, can shoot the ball, can handle it. I think he'll bring a lot to the team.
While Jones doesn't have to worry about making the team, he's up against guys playing for their NBA lives. Former Michigan State star Charlie Bell is hoping to catch on. So is Dickie Simpkins, who won 3 rings with the Bulls.
As you know, it's different in college, and I expected that, and I expect you're going to have to work harder than you did in college. And, you know, that's what we're going to have to do. And I mean, I'm up for the challenge, and I'm going to come out here and try to prove myself.
Not everybody here is fighting for a roster spot. Ron Artest showed up to help himself and to help the rookies.
I talked to him today, and I told him he got to take me under his wing and show me a little around the town, and, you know, to show me how to come out here and work hard and to be accountable every day. And so, you know, we're going to get together and do that.
He asked me to, and you know, I felt good that he asked me to do that. So, I mean, I work, and I'm a gym rat, so I'm sure he is too. He looked like he's a good player, getting up, skying above the rim. So, I mean, it'd be good for us. He's strong, so hopefully he can give me some resistance down there on the block.
He looked pretty quick too, the way he was running around.
Big. I don't know how much he weighed, but he got big muscles, and he could jump. And he had a jump shot like right in my face, so he might be trying to take my spot next year.
So you don't want to teach him too much?
Yeah, I don't teach him too much. I can't teach him no defense.
After a few days of practice in Indy, the Pacers summer leaguers head to Orlando for games against the rest of the NBA, another place this rookie can show his stuff. Eric Waxler, Channel 13 Eyewitness Sports.
Yeah, those Pacers have 2 more practices tomorrow over at the Fieldhouse. As baseball pauses for the All-Star break, it's also remembering one of its greatest heroes with the passing of Ted Williams this weekend. Baseball's greatest hitter leaves a lasting impression.
Ted Williams hit like no one else. He was a batter few pitchers wanted to face. That includes Anderson's Carl Erskine.
I almost faced him in the All-Star game in 54. He was on the on-deck circle, and I got the last out before he came up, which I was thankful for.
Erskine pitched for the Brooklyn Dodgers for more than 10 years. But because they were in different leagues, he only faced Williams in spring training.
The thing I remember about him as a pitcher was you could not make him chase a bad ball. He was just absolutely fixed on the strike zone. And, of course, he got a reputation of having such a good eye that I think the umpire said, well, if he takes a pitch, it's got to be a ball because he didn't swing at it.
Ted Williams did pass through Indianapolis on his way to superstardom. He played at Busch Stadium as a minor leaguer in 1938. Norm Beauplay was the PA announcer.
When he came here, he was playing with Minneapolis. Oney Bush was his manager. And at that time, Ted was, in a quandary. He wanted to be a fireman. And him and Bush was arguing and going back and forth and everything. Finally, everything simmered down. And in 38, he led the league in everything.
Even today's players can appreciate what Ted Williams meant to baseball. But those who saw him play in person will never forget what it was like to see greatness at work.
I was amazed at him on account of he'd be in the dugout and he'd want to go up and hit all the time. And he always had that bat and he was boning the bat all the time. And he didn't care about defense or anything like that. But he was a one hell of a hitter.
The rumors that flew about how to pitch to Williams, no place in the strike zone was safe.
Some nice observations about a true American hero. Still to come on the 13 Sports Jam, we'll go back to Kansas City, where Foyt and Leyendijk were racing this afternoon. We'll also go back in time 25 years to a time that was very shaky for one of our beloved sports franchises. And what was Tony George really looking at during Wednesday's press conference? The whole ball of wax has a hidden camera exclusive.
And
13 Sports Jam is brought to you in part by Hardee's.
If you're gonna eat the Philly roast beef sandwich loaded with grilled onions at Hardee's, learn to deal with it. The Philly roast beef sandwich with grilled onions at Hardee's.
Severe weather season is upon us, and all of us at SkyTrack Weather want to make sure you're prepared. I am meteorologist Chris Wright. You can start by getting your copy of the SkyTrack Weather Brochure. Either pick one up at any Central Indiana H.H. Gregg location or send a self-addressed stamped envelope to this address. There's important life-saving information for you and your family on how to survive tornadoes, floods, how to protect yourself from lightning, and much more. The SkyTrack Weather Brochure. Pick up your copy today.
Brought to you by GM and H.H. Gregg.
Come on. Yeah, I'm still in the car.
10 minutes, an hour? I've got no idea. This is ridiculous.
Can't wait to get your new Jetta? And with the offers going on now, why would you?
What is a number one ranking? It's a goal, an honor, a badge. But it's also a weight, a target, and an albatross. But for those who think they may want to relieve me of this burden, the number one ranking is a dare. A dare that looks them in the eye and says, here I am. U.S. Open champion and number one ranked Leighton Hewitt at the RCA Championships.
As we told you earlier on the 13 Sports Jam, this was a significant weekend for the A.J. Foyt family. His driver today, Ayrton Daré, taking him back to the winner's circle for the first time in over 3 years. And it was a clean sweep for Foyt as his grandson won the inaugural Infinity Pro Series event. This will be the support series for the IRL and gave some up-and-coming drivers a chance to get used to the high-speed ovals. A.J. Foyt IV winning the Kansas 100 on the pole. He beat out actor Jason Priestley to the checkered flag. Ari Leyendijk Jr. also competing in this new series. The win for the 18-year-old Foyt comes 21 years after his grandfather's last victory. Before we send you back to another work week, time to lift your spirits a bit. Eric Waxler provides the comic relief in the whole ball of wax.
Hi, everybody. The appeals process is over. We have a verdict. It's the whole ball of wax, fully endorsed by Team Green. We now join Tony George explaining his ruling on the Indy 500.
At the time that the yellow dashboard light system was activated,
I've got a perfect puzzle for you. Hoopa, hoopa, doopa-dee-dee. If you are wise, you'll listen to me.
What do you get when you guzzle down sweets?
Eating as much as an elephant eats.
What are you at getting terribly fat?
Since I don't have the last page of my notes.
Okay, we'll get back to that. The whole ball of wax doesn't have time to wait. We've got a job to do that's always first rate. Remember, you can run, but you can't hide. This is what happens when worlds collide.
If you're not greedy, you will go far. You will live in happiness too.
Now back to the IRL press conference. Yes, we've got ourselves quite a mess. What's next? Well, it's anyone's guess.
I took a low punch shot, but I doubt that he's falling in the
damn.
That is close.
time.
I believe that ball landed in a spectator.
That's what I call a bad lie. That's the whole ball of wax. I think Tony George is on the phone. I got to go.
All right. Thank you, Eric Waxler, for that. Later on the 13 Sports Jam, we'll take you back in time a quarter of a century ago when things were looking rather bleak for the Pacers.
By the time there was only 5 minutes left in the telethon, the convention center here was jam-packed with excited fans. And then the big announcement.
Bob, we're at 8,028.
This is your appetite talking. How about something tasty?
Introducing Arby's Market Fresh Ultimate BLT.
Ooh, the bread is so soft. All that bacon, so peppery. And those toppings, so fresh.
Arby's new Market Fresh Ultimate BLT.
BLTs me.
Made fresh to order. It'll change the way you think about fast food.
Give in to your grown-up tastes.
What's wrong, Jim?
I think I've grown a second evil head.
Oh, I'm sorry. What if we go get a refreshing Mike's hard iced tea? Would that help?
I didn't know Mike's made a hard iced tea.
You bet they do.
A hard day calls for a hard iced tea. Make it Mike's.
Lemon clear malt beverage.
Lots of insurance companies claim to be revolutionizing the industry and achieving unprecedented success on Wall Street. I'm sure they are. All I know is, after a tornado nearly destroyed our home, Revolutionary Ideas didn't deliver a claims check the very next day, and Wall Street Success didn't hoist that maple tree off our car. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance did. We need an insurance company with solutions. That's the only claim that interests me.
Solutions you need from a company.
Hey, I know where you should take your family. To Bob Evans' restaurant.
Bob Evans is a great place for kids.
They have that spaghetti and meatballs.
With 11 great kids' meals starting at $1.99.
Chicken quesadillas.
Including some new ones.
They even have a smiley face with chocolate.
And the new Reese's I'm Smiling Sundae for dessert.
With buttercups for the eyeballs. I love every bite.
Bob Evans, a menu full of smiles.
Do you remember what you were doing 25 years ago? Many of you played a major role in the future sports landscape of our city. Here's a look back to the Save the Pacers telethon from 1977.
Waking up in the convention center.
The cost of making the transition from the ABA to the NBA in 1977 was taking a major financial toll on the Pacers. The last resort was a telethon to save the team.
I mean, it was kind of that quintessential Indiana Hoosier kind of feeling, and it was just like an old-time pep rally.
The Pacers needed to sell 8,000 season tickets or face losing the club to another city. Local celebrities and dignitaries showed up here at the Indiana Convention Center and took turns working round the clock at the telethon. Channel 13's Bob Gregory was front and center stage along with the ringleader of the event, Coach Bobby Slick Leonard, who is also the club's general manager.
Just being around Slick and Nancy Leonard, I mean, how motivational those people were, and he was just always so committed.
Our actual count is 6,730. As of 12:25, we've got an hour and 50 minutes to go.
In typical fashion, the Pacers and their fans celebrated a last-second victory.
Bob, we're at 8,028.
If the Pacers don't survive, do we get the Colts in 1984? Does the amateur sports initiative really take hold as it did in the early 80s? I think that was really a major, major component to Indianapolis being able to build itself not only as a great town, but a great sports town.
The Pacers' financial troubles were far from over, but the telethon of 77 was clearly the first of many more winning moments to come.
And who knows, maybe 25 years from now, the Pacers will finally have some championship rings to show us. Thanks for staying up late with us tonight. That's the 13 Sports Jam. Dave Calabro is back tomorrow. I'm Dick Rea. Have a great rest of your holiday weekend.